Hey, what's going on? Gotta share a little quick message with you once again. What advice are you willing to take? I literally just left a store, and you know, I love C-store owners. I love all you guys. You're awesome. But there's one thing that's holding you back a lot of times, and it's your ability to take advice. And what do I mean by that? I'm not saying me just give you advice and you listen. I'm saying that as somebody who's been around the industry for 18 years, and I do call myself an expert in the industry, and there are other people that would say they would agree, when you ask me about ways to grow your sales, there's a good chance that the answer I give you, you don't want to hear, or you're going to disagree with. But at the end of the day, you either need to A, keep asking questions, or B, actually do what I say, or C, just let it go. Just be done and be happy with what you have. I've talked to a couple of people in the last few days where I'm trying to help grow sales, and I'm throwing ideas out, and many times I'm met with complete resistance. And so, if you are going to resist and ignore and debunk everything that someone's going to give you as advice on how to grow your sales and not try it, why even ask? Why even ask for advice? So, you know, my point and the point of making this video is the people that I'm going to be able to help and I'm going to be able to work with have got to have an open mind. They've got to be ready and willing to invest in their business in some form or fashion. And I understand during this time that money's tight and, you know, through COVID, nobody really knows what's going to happen. You know, how open up are we going to be as a country? How much are people going to move around? But the one thing I do know about the C-store industry, and it has been a trend for well over 8 years, food is the way to go. I talked about that in another video, but when I give you the advice of getting into food and you say I've tried it, at the end of the day, what needs to be happening in your mind is I say, okay, food's the way to go. You need to say, okay, now let me think, what kind of food can I sell? And there's no better way to find out how to grow your sales than asking your customers what they want. Number one, ask your customers what it is that they want. I go into a lot of C-stores and literally the only thing they offer is pizza. That's it. Now granted, pizza's good. Pizza's gonna sell. But at the end of the day, you're gonna hit peaks and valleys on pizza as people get tired of the same old stuff. And so, you know, for example, the advice I gave somebody earlier was, you have a pizza oven. You don't want to invest in any more equipment. You don't want to get into fried food. You need to be thinking about all the things you can run through that pizza oven. I told him, I said, well, what about a hoagie? What about a pizza sub? What about a ham and cheese sub, hot subs? What about a hot sandwich? What about things like that?
Turn left onto Old Hickory Boulevard.
Sorry about that. But my point being is, going back, whose advice are you actually willing to listen to? Do you know so much about the industry that you will totally ignore and totally shut down any advice given? What that is, that's a mental block. That's a mental block. I mean, let's go back to Thomas Edison, I believe it was. How many ways did he find not to do a light bulb? It's thousands of ways he found not to do a light bulb, but guess what he did find? He found out how to do it, right? How many ways are you willing to try to grow your sales? And if you want a shortcut in growing your sales, I gave it to you already, but I'm going to give it to you again. Ask your customers what they want, right? Even through C-Store Secrets, I'm learning
at the stop sign,
the things.
Turn left onto Old Hickory Boulevard.
Even through C-Store Secrets, I'm learning the things that will actually help you guys that are watching these videos. You know, originally, I thought that all of you would all be about profit. That's all you cared about. And why did I think that? Because all that most C-Store owners care about and talk about, 9 times out of 10, is price. And I've made videos about price as well. So I thought, well,
if all they care
about is profit, then price will be the next thing they care about. And I was wrong. I'm finding that a lot of you C-store owners want to know how to operate your C-store at a high level so that it can function without you. To putting systems and processes in place and getting your employees to do what needs to be done every day so that you can manage instead of run the store. I'm finding there's a lot of people out there that want that information. And so as a salesman, as somebody who has all kinds of information that will help C-store owners, I'm finding that's the trigger button that'll get us to have a conversation. Now, I can help you with your Facebook page. I can teach you how to run a Facebook page. I can teach you how to create professional looking Facebook images. I can teach you how to create your own digital menus on your own. There are all kinds of things that I can do that will help you save money in your C-store, but guess what? So far, that's not what C-store owners want. And so again, I keep going back to this. When you want to grow your business, be open-minded. Don't shut things down, but think about how can I make that work? With what I have, if I don't want to spend money, with what I have, how can I make that work? Does that make sense? So open your mind. Open your mind to the possibilities. Open your heart and your brain and ask your customers. They're going to give you everything you need to know if you ask correctly. Everything you need to know. Just ask. They'll tell you. Okay? That's my advice for you right now. If you want to grow your sales, ask your customers and be willing to listen. If you have that no mentality on everything that they say, you are dead in the water and you are wasting your time even asking the question. Hopefully this helps you guys. One thing that I am trying to do is speak more to psychology and the psychology of you saying no to everything. That's what limits you. That's what limits you and is going to create a situation where you can't compete with the people who are innovative and who are looking at the possibilities. So, once again, hope this message helped you, and I'll see you again soon.